Parshas Bahar B'chukosai, we're moving on to Sheni. Just a little point we missed in the first Aliyah was Onah, the fact that you have to have a certain responsibility about how you do commerce and business, and you can't ever jip or cheat, and the sales have to be accurate. And we're going to circle back and explain that in these Parshias, there's a very big emphasis that almost looks like socialism, where Hashem gets involved in everything that we do financially. We have to make sure that we don't cheat. We have to make sure that we treat our servants properly. We have to make sure that we lend without ribis. We have to make sure that that all our commercial activities are done with the understanding that there's oversight from the Ribbono Shel Olam, with a great responsibility to our brothers. And in Sheni, there's something very unique, something extremely uplifting. Once we were told to let our land lie fallow, Hashem gives us a haftacha, which only an eternal God could do. He says, "Vechitomru," if you'll say, "Ma nochal bashana shvius," what are we going to eat in the seventh year? "Hen lo nizra velo nesa festivu aseinu." Hashem says, "Vetzivisias birchosi lochem bashana shishis." I will make sure that there'll be double bounty in the sixth year. Only an eternal God, confident in his ability, like the Ribbono Shel Olam, could say that. And this is one of the most beautiful proofs of his existence. Shemitah is to encourage in us a certain emuna and a certain betochen. I'd like to point out something that's not very well known, but the pasuk tells us, "V'achalta min atvua yoshan," you'll eat old. It doesn't mean yoshan, chodash. Yoshan means you'll eat old wheat. "Ad ashana chis ad boy tvuasa teichlu yoshan," you'll be eating old wheat. Now, why is that something that's nice? What's the encouragement to keep Shemitah because you'll be eating old wheat? Now, people that make bread know that it's always a balance between the gluten, which is the sticky part of the dough, and the carbon dioxide, which is the part that makes the dough airy. It's always a balance to get the right medium because bread has to be puffed. Back in the olden days, that balance was always very accomplished by the fact that they used to age their wheat. Aged wheat makes the gluten somewhat weaker and allows the carbon dioxide to escape and makes the perfect balance. Today, we don't have that. Our wheat that we eat is processed about a month ago, and therefore, we have to introduce other different types of chemicals. Some people will know that there's a chemical called L-cysteine. It comes from human hair. It's in order to introduce that balance, we have to use completely unnatural techniques. Hashem says you'll keep Shemitah, you'll be eating old grain. Old grain is the most beautiful grain to make the most perfect bread. It has in it the ability to neutralize the gluten, which ordinarily would be too strong and would keep the carbon dioxide trapped. So this is a blessing a lot of people don't notice. The Yoshan is a tremendous blessing. The pasuk continues and tells us about the concept of a steyachuza. When you get an inheritance and the land comes to you from your fathers and a person, God forbid, has to sell, well, then it's important that his relatives should come and try to redeem that piece of land. What's the purpose of this mitzvah? Why is this mitzvah so important? There's something so unusual about the Haftarah, which we're not going to read, and that's when Yirmiyahu is in jail, worried for his survival, because he's seen as if he's a spy and someone working with the king of Bavel. And Hashem tells him in a message, look, your uncle Hanamel ben Shalom is going to come to you, and he's going to offer you his field because he has to go. And I'm going to tell you to buy it properly. Do it with Edim, do it with a shtar, make sure it's registered. You're going to have this, put it in a safe place. And Yirmiyahu listens and does everything he's told. And then after everything is done, he cries out to Hashem. He says, why are we doing this? He says in almost a beautiful pasuk, he says, he praises Hashem. He talks about the godliness of Hashem. He says, and you know this land could have been ours, but it isn't ours because we didn't obey you. He says, Hine hasoy lelo izbou ha'ir lelachda. All the moat breakers and the armies are surrounding the city. And the land is practically being given to the Babylonians who are fighting. God, you see, this is what's happening. And now you tell me, you tell me to buy the field from my uncle? and to redeem it. V'ho'ed edim, v'ir nitna bi'adaka. Explain to me the sense of why you told me to do this, O God. After he did it, he was a law-abiding citizen. Now he wants to know, why did I do this? And Hashem answers him the most beautiful answer. He says, Hine ani Hashem alekei kol basar. I'm the God of all flesh. Hamimeni yipole kol dover. It's my land. It could turn in a second. It could be that the land was quiet for 2,000 years and no one came, and then 1948, and we have a land that belongs to us. Hayipale mimeni dover, just buy, don't worry. That's the whole purpose of what I'm showing you over here. Shemitah, it's mine. Listen to me, you get it. Stay with me, you own it. Reject me, you lose it. But it could always come back. That's the concept of a stay achuzah.